Cedar Point. We are here at Cedar Point, my favorite place in the world, once again today. And today is really going to function as just opening day for us. It's opening day part two because we weren't able to ride so many things because of the weather the last time that we were here. Already this morning, we've had some weather-related issues, but we are on our way to ride as many things as we possibly can get done, especially that we haven't hit yet this season. So I hope you're ready. I hope you're excited, and let's go. Just a quick warning here at the beginning of this video. Sound quality is awful until about the 13-minute mark. Because my phone was doing something really weird, so I went out and got some headphones at that point. So if the sound quality is going to bother you, then skip ahead. Let's go!
It is 7 o'clock right now, and I am on an entirely empty road. But we are ready for Cedar Point once again today. And I'm here! 5 minutes late, it's 9:05 right now.
Look at all these great people helping us get in. I love how organized Cedar Point has been this year. I think they have more workers this year. Because I don't think we had this many people helping last year.
Every single year, no matter what, at some point, I lose my pass. And that's what happened last time I was here. Had to get online to find my pass in order to get the dining plan last time I was here. So today we're going to go reinstate that pass, but gives me the chance to show you guys where to go. If you have lost your pass, you can follow my lead as to what you need to do. When you walk in over to the right, there is a ticket booth after you enter security, and it says tickets in big bold letters. So that's where you head to renew your pass.
There aren't a ton of people ready to go in. So, I mean, of course, probably a lot of them have been let in already. But
it's now open.
Tickets.
Please step to window 8.
Come into here. Oh, I don't even know where to go here.
Please step to window 7.
Go around. Man, the chains look very confusing. So I think let's come down here. Also, don't forget about the ready station and the ATM if you need it.
A couple people comment, why is there an ATM with the ready station? That's in case you have kids and you don't have cash with you, but you need to get some cash so that then you can make several cards for your kids to have some money to walk around.
All right, now Raptor is testing. It is not actually one of the early entry rides this year. This little gem is. And I have half a mind to hit that first. I'm not sure what the lines would be like. And right now, they don't have lines on the app because early entry does not include line wait times on the app. So you just kind of got to walk around and hope you find something that you want to ride.
Now, generally, I would say do not hit something like Gatekeeper this early in the morning for early park entry because it's just too much. Like, people can see it right away and everyone runs to it. Gatekeeper, I usually haven't seen that be the case with Gatekeeper, but Raptor isn't open now. Although people are running to Raptor. I'm not sure why they're running to Raptor. It's not gonna open for another hour.
As you can tell, it is not an incredibly packed morning here. But today, it's pretty solidly decent lines, it's looking like. We'll see what Gatekeeper looks like once we get there. Well, the line is very short, but why do I have all these people over here? This ride has been temporarily delayed.
Hey, well, I am not waiting for a temporary delay. That's not happening. So, we just move on.
Now, both Millennium Force and Magnum are options for me for early park entry. Millennium Force is this way,
Magnum is this way.
Neither usually get huge lines, but things have changed a little bit here. Okay, and there's a line for Millennium Force too.
Why are there so many rides down? I have no idea. Quite honestly though, I'm here for early park entry. There are tons of people right here waiting. And I'm not okay with it.
This is Nick.
What's going on?
he just came up and said hi. So what's your favorite ride here, Nick?
Oh gosh. Between Millennium, Steel Vengeance.
The Millennium was out when we were kids, right?
Yeah.
So like that.
Well,
yeah.
I was too wussy to ride it for the longest time. And I finally ballsed up enough to get on it. I rode it yesterday by myself. So that I can ride it.
Is that your first time?
No.
Okay,
no.
I was going to say.
No, but when I was younger, I couldn't ride
it. Gotcha. Well, it's nice to meet you, Nick.
Yeah, nice to meet you, bro.
So Nick said his daughter was going to ride Iron Dragon. And she asked up at the front why everything was down. And they said there was lightning in the area. So that must be why, right there. So. Also, I forgot to look up the shows, so we're going to check out shows right now. Just saw people on Valraven. Valraven isn't even an early entry ride. And it's 30 minutes before the park opens, so.
Half a mind to try to hit Valraven, since I know it's open. Even though it shouldn't be open, like the website says, it's not part of early entry. Well, I do think sometimes they open things early if they can anyway. But yeah, that's surprising to me. So anyway though, right now I'm just gonna continue on the trajectory where I'm headed and we'll hit whatever we can hit. Today's my like first real day back at the park. So we're just gonna hit what we can.
I'm now also seeing people on Iron Dragon. So I have a feeling they are opening some of the rides.
It's not a drill. Lusty Lil's little abrasion is on. You have no idea how excited I am. 1:30, I think 3:30 and 4:30, I think. So it doesn't run that many times, but I'm gonna definitely have to hit that today at some point. We're just gonna hit Magnum. It's the first thing we found today. We're just gonna go for that. How long have you been coming to Cedar Point, first of all?
Since I was little.
Okay.
I was scared of roller coasters
me
for...
Me too.
I was scared of roller coasters there for a couple years, and then I started liking them.
Okay, sure. So what's your favorite ride now?
My favorite?
Yeah.
Millennium Force.
Okay.
But the best ride here is Steel Engine.
Okay, obviously. Yeah. That's exact. I just had the same answer from another person just like 5 minutes ago. So. Well, Sebastian, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you,
good
too.
Good to see ya. Have a good one.
Thank you.
I'm not gonna lie, this is more of a line for Magnum than I like to do, but it's early park entry, it's fine. And even then, it's only gonna take tops 10 minutes, if not less than that.
When things are closed, it throws the park dispersion like all over. So everything is really weird as far as like where people go, stuff like that, because where they would normally go first, they don't go first. So when things are closed, just roll with the punches and keep on moving. Eventually things will kind of even out again, but initially you're gonna kind of find some weird lines, and that's why you never can really know exactly what the lines are gonna do. All I can give is like best guesses as to what the best order of things to do while you're here in the park is.
Here we are in Frontier Town. And I believe I see a massive line out of the gate at Maverick. And it looks like Mav is testing. We might walk by just to see it though. Oh, but they have opened the line for Maverick. You know, right now might be the time to do it. It's still early park entry, although the line looks like it's going all the way around here. So I might have to backtrack through the line. That's not particularly helpful to me.
We're not going to hit Maverick right now. It's too long of a line for me by a long shot. And instead we're gonna hit something else.
that may give us a little bit more bang for our time right now. It looks like the inside, all of the back and forths were all completely full. So instead of doing that, we'll get a beer at some point and come ride it. Maybe I'll ride it with Given later, but we'll see what we do. On Tap opens up on June 4th. It makes absolutely no sense that Millennium Force is still not open. As much as I love that Cedar Point is trying to be cautious and careful, it is extremely annoying that so many things are constantly down, especially toward the beginning of this year. It's really putting kind of a sour taste in, honestly, in my mouth for Cedar Point, which is weird because it's hard to put a sour taste in my mouth for Cedar Point. It is 10 o'clock. Millennium Force is supposed to be an early entry ride. Rougarou is supposed to be an early entry ride. Both are down.
I get safety, but lightning strikes happened over an hour ago.
We can hit up Iron Dragon right now. It is running, so we're going to hit that one now. Iron Dragon, even if the full queue is absolutely filled to the max, it's going to be like a 15, maybe a 20 minute wait.
Carefully and carefully, make sure all those loose articles are secure. You're going to sit down straight up or straight over your shoulders.
It has been 5 minutes. The first train just left. And the second train is coming into the station right now.
At 4:30, there's a Lusty Lil show at that point. So that's when I'm gonna head off to that show so that then I can escape the rain. If you can kind of get an idea of the way your day's gonna go and of, you know, pay attention to your weather apps, try to get as much of an idea as you possibly can. And at that point, figure out where you can go that would be your best thing. That would be your best option for the day. Say the Maverick is closed. It does say Valraven is a 35 minute wait. I don't believe it.
If the app says one thing and what you see says completely another, don't do it. Or make your own judgment call based on whatever you're seeing. Right now I'm headed out of the park because if you've noticed, I've only been pretty much focusing the camera this way. Because I've noticed that when I point it at me, it's very, very quiet. So, I am planning to go grab my headphones so that we can have better sound quality. So, we're headed out to the car for just a minute.
It says 1 hour for Raptor.
In the intro, but we found Given.
What's up?
I thought we might run into him today.
I was over here just like vlogging and I'm like, my social anxiety is up here because I'm by myself and then I run into him. I'm like, what's up?
Looking like it's music days, guys. We've got bands galore. Well, after that fiasco, finally found the car. Like I said, pay attention to where you park. That way you don't have to deal with that kind of stuff. Guys, let's go. Turns out this was the best day for me to have lost my ticket. Because coming in for early entry, there wasn't anything open anyway. Where to, Given?
Honestly, I'm cool with anything. I just want to get a ride on pretty much anything major today that we didn't hit on opening day.
Well, Future Trent here and his wonderful tan line. If you haven't yet, please press that subscribe button. We would love to have you guys join this roller coaster and theme park loving family. And also, if you've enjoyed something in this video or something's been helpful to you so far, please press that like button. Also, please leave a comment with something for me to find out about Cedar Point in the future. Now, if you want to find out how I got this sunburn, then just keep on watching. Let's go.
The piers have gone down. Everyone's coming out of the queue, or at least a lot of people are. I'm sure they have the option to stay if they want to, but
here comes a marching band. When something's down, enjoy whatever else you can find. Given has some better takes than I do. He knows some of the history better than I do. So, like I said, go follow him. Last video I said that. Do it again today. Problem with Cedar Point, since it is on an island, you do have, at least I've noticed this before, a lot of times it seems like weather, even at like Mackinac Island, it's the same kind of thing. Weather will go right around the island on both sides. So you'll end up with lightning or rain or whatever really hitting really hard all around the outside. If lightning hits, everything closes down. And that's what's happening literally right now. It's partly cloudy. It's actually really nice. It's really warm. Maybe I will go get my bathing suit, but right now we can't do anything here really, except for maybe the flat rides, which is why even part two, maybe less of a part two. Maybe we'll have a part three redemption.
A part three or part four at this point.
For the last hour, the only thing to do has been to eat. So look at that line for Back BQ. Actually, it's not the worst I've ever seen. But it is big. Kevin, are you just bad luck? Do you just find all the valleys of
all
the rides?
Anytime I come to the park, you know, it's never a bad day at Cedar Point. But the days that I come, it's like, oh, it's got a storm, or oh, it's got to be windy and nothing's open.
All right, so Kevin said Miss Keats has changed this year. We're going to go check it out. It certainly has a lower line than Back BQ did. And last year I did have some incredible fish fillets here. But I did not like almost anything else. So we'll see what we find here. If it's like Tex-Mex bowl, which it definitely looks like, then that may be a really good option for us. So let's go. Now, while the food has gotten a re-theme, the restaurant itself has not.
Can I do pork? Can I do cheese and sour cream?
Here's the finished product. And here's the other finished product. Cedar Point, you couldn't give me much of a smaller glass of water, could you? Really? I was not at all impressed with the way the chicken looked, so I changed it from chicken to steak. So that looked a lot better, a lot less greasy. Also, the black beans are not drained when they put the black beans in with your chips and stuff. So I'm just not a big fan. So now individually, yeah, like the steak is dry. Black beans, like not being drained on the salad, I don't mind. I don't know if you mind it on the chips, but when the chips get soggy, that really bothers me. So it is a fairly decent sized portion. It's not a very shareable meal though. I wouldn't say that this is a place where you're gonna come and be able to, you know, like share with your kids or things like that. Unless your appetite just isn't that big in theme park. You do get like some variety of flavor with this though. That may be worth it just in itself. So okay, it's done. And here's my final thought. It is a step up from what Miss Keats was last year. It's still not particularly good, I don't think. The healthy option, like I may be back because I was able to do the base of the lettuce, and that's a lot healthier than getting chips and all that. And I'm trying to make these 20,000 steps count for me each day. And when I get drinks all day, you know, like three drinks during a day, I know I'm not doing myself favors. So I'm trying to eat as healthy as I possibly can. So I do enjoy having the like healthy option. But there's a lot of stuff that I think kind of was wrong. I think the chicken was very sketchy looking. Just did not enjoy that at all. And as soon as I saw that they were getting the chicken, which I told them to get, I was like, no, let's do the steak instead because it just doesn't look good. The black beans not being drained, again, on lettuce, not a big deal. It almost ended up being like a dressing with that case. In that case, but when you have chips, then it gets really soggy. So, you know, not having the holes in the holder is kind of an issue. There was just a lot of little things like that that I think made this whole meal just subpar rather than something that really feels good. I'd rather them bring back the fish that they had last year because that was delicious. That was the only thing I ate here that I just thoroughly enjoyed. But I mean, like I said, it may be a step up from the barbecue that they had last year.
Okay, every day here at Cedar Point is a vacation, so it's 11:45. I'm getting a drink anyway. Don't judge me. Let's go. So, they still...
the comically small water.
But they gave me two. And it's filled with ice, so at least it'll last, like, more than one drink. We've also got a beer. This is the Great Lakes. Oh, it has some...
That's out of Cleveland.
It has some cool... Some cool, like, undertones in the taste. Yeah, it's like it gets kind of sweet. Like, it starts bitter, and then it gets a little bit sweet. And then it gets bitter. Actually, now it's like a sweet finish. My taste buds are all messed up. Whatever. Anyway, it's good. I like it. All right, we're going to Maverick. This is going to be quite a line, but I think everything is going to be quite a line. So it says an hour and a quarter for the wait right now. Time starts now. Let's go. I said earlier, though, I've got a beer. That's what matters. And it's a tall boy. So, like, this will be a fun line, at least. We got a live show going on over there. Right now, we are at an hour, like, right under an hour, like, 58 minutes. And then we are going up into the stairs at this very moment. So it may be an hour and 10 minutes, something like that. It's not gonna be long. Line has gotten shorter since we got in line though, which means we didn't necessarily make the best decision. I think lines though have gotten shorter because there have been more lines that have opened up since we got in this line. So I think that's part of the reason why. Probably an hour right now. Are you ready?
Exactly an hour. Yeah.
Woo! Yeah, 2007, baby! Gavin, how was it?
Well, that was my first ride of the season on Maverick. Woo! Great, as always. Raptor's still my favorite in the park, but this is a very, very, very
hence the shirt.
Hence the shirt, exactly. But, you know, Maverick is a very, very close second. So.
Nice. It does kind of, so it can sometimes hurt your unmentionable. So keep that in mind. Ow, I just wanted to show off these mugs. I am a fan of those mugs. We've also got some more Maverick merch too. We've seen that all in the past, but I don't think I hit the mugs, so. Here's the other side of the new place to eat. We do have a bit of some music that's definitely giving me Disney Frontierland vibes. Okay, so this used to be a walkthrough for the path too. And I'm sorry, but I'm bitter that it doesn't exist anymore. First though, this is gonna be a nice long line. So we're gonna get one more drink. Should I make t-shirts that say Toasty on them?
Toasty. You know, it's funny. The fact that because Ohio, like, Australia, kind of the same. Like,
yeah, they're kind
of
like.
Even Mesquite's has more of a line right now than it did at 12 o'clock or at 11 o'clock when we ate. All right, it's looking like a two-hour wait for Steel Vengeance. In the hot sun.
All right though, even though this is hot and it's going to be a very long line, at least we don't have to worry about it raining. At least not right at this moment. But they've taken away all of the like areas above for you to be able to hang out. So any place that was made for shade is completely gone. I don't know why,
But it would be really nice if they had those shade things up at the beginning of this year also. I'm sure they weren't expecting May to be nearly as hot as it is right now.
Oh, wait.
Okay, so I definitely thought this was going to be a 2-hour wait. It's not a 2-hour wait. It's going to be something more like an hour and a half, maybe? I'm not even sure if it's going to be that one much. It may be more like an hour. So hopefully this is going to be a pretty decent time. Right now it's been 50 minutes, and we are getting pretty close up to the very front of the line. Hill Vengeance is a fantastic ride, and it is a ride that I think is worthwhile for everyone to ride. It is kind of scary. It does feel like you could potentially die. What do you think about it?
The whole ride is so out of control from start to finish. I mean, even before you head up the lift hill, you're getting tossed out of your seat. Then the whole ride from there is just, you're not in your seat. Yeah. It's like...
No, you're just... You're just bouncing up and down.
Yeah, literally, the whole ride makes you feel like you're a basketball. So an hour and a half, 2 hours at the most is what you're going to want to wait on a busy day for this ride if you want to get the most prime ride time in.
The one hitch in our get-along is the fast lane system, which I don't begrudge the fast lane people. They spent a lot of money on these tickets, but it does mean that this many people coming in all at one time is going to give us less chances of it being just an hour and having it be a little bit longer than that. It feels so good to be in the cold, in the shade. I wouldn't even call it cold, but in the shade. And we are now on our way in to the lockers, really, for Steel Vengeance. So if you're not familiar with Steel Vengeance, you do have to put your stuff in a locker system. This locker system works like the lockers that they would have at Costco, where basically you come in, you put your lockers in one side, and you take your lockers out the other side. So once you're done, you'll walk all the way around this ride, and then back into another entrance close by the main entrance, and then you'll take your stuff out of your lockers. You use the passcode. I'll show it all to you. Everything needs to go in the lockers. These lockers are free. They do feel kind of like a nerve-wracking kind of a thing. Like when you're first coming, you're like, are they really free though? They are 100% free, and I'll walk you through the process right now. All right, so the process is this. You come on in, you do the rent. You do. Then you pick whatever thing you want here. So I'm just going to pick the pen. And once again, you do the same thing. Pick the pen. It's a different one every single time. So right here, your locker is locker number 227. So here's the locker. It's very, very small, but it's enough for wallets, keys, and whatever else you may need to put in it. Even my hat will fit in it. Not even your glasses can be left, and they do have metal detectors, so they will check your body for any spare keys or anything like that that may be in your locker. So you gotta put everything away, including the camera. There's Given.
One crazy ride later.
All right,
So I got my phone, but that's all I got. And now I'm going to show you how you actually get into these lockers to retrieve your items. So tap here to begin, reopen, and then put in your birthday, and then do a pen. I mean, because that's what I did. Go over and find it. So it'll already be open, and then all you need to do is just grab the stuff out of your locker. All right, to get to your locker, you go down these stairs, come back over here, around this way. And then locker retrieval is over here, right next to the normal entrance. And you'll see a sign right after the Dippin' Dots that says locker retrieval. Walk down that way and follow the rest of my instructions. Over here we have another drink station where sometimes you can get drinks. This drink station is not always open, but frequently it is. Lusty Lil is starting her shows. Ah! I can hear her singing too, but we have a date with her at about 4:30 today, so it's okay. I'll take advantage of her services then. Okay, there is another Coca-Cola Freestyle right here too. Several of them in Frontier Town. And then we have Cedar Creek Hollow right here, which is the bridge that we used to go across on Antique Autos. They also do have a refresh station right there. And we will look into that restaurant later. Let's go over here to pizza real fast. Ooh, they're having a glass blowing demonstration. I need to get to one of those at some point this year as I walk past it. All the stores are open, the candle shop, the candy shop, the wood maker, Fort Sandusky Mining Company. Man, I have not seen like three of these open at all in the last year. Still nothing over here.
You can go into Fort.
Actually just in here for a glass of water, but we're gonna see. Maybe I'll get something else. How is it given?
Strong but really good.
Most drinks here are going to cost you about $13. A beer sometimes is like 10 for a small boy. For a tall boy, you're still gonna pay usually around 13 bucks. Wait, how much is a White Claw?
White Claw, I paid 12 bucks for a White Claw.
Okay.
This is only $2 more, or a dollar more, I think.
Okay, so even a White Claw is gonna cost you about $12. So expect to pay quite a bit for your drinks here at Cedar Point. Not had much in the way of water at all. So even this cost me about $4. They're expensive. But at least I can kind of carry this around for just a little bit of the day and refill it if I need to. Those tiny little shot glasses that they put the water in, I can't with those. Garter was not open last time I was here. I don't think they have any bands because I saw those earlier, those signs earlier today. So it's just a nice air-conditioned place for us to sit for right now until the bands actually start coming in. But it's a good place to grab your Panda Express, come in and eat, or grab a drink. Oh yeah. Hey, I recognize you.
Hi guys.
Skylar, how are you doing?
I'm good.
Good. Hey, what's your channel called?
Karen Polly.
Karen Polly. Okay, awesome.
We're going real fast, if that's okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Go for it. I'll get some crowd shots in. Okay, so it says a 30-minute wait for Rougarou right now. So we're gonna check that out
right at this moment. Let's go. All right, so this is a decent line. Not the worst I've ever seen for Rougarou though, and it shouldn't be a horrible wait. The wait time out in front says 30 minutes. We'll see how long this actually takes, if the wait time is actually accurate or not. Line at 3:27. We'll see how long this line actually takes for us to get into it all the way through. Are you excited?
I'm so excited.
They do have pop machines in the queue here for you also, and vending machines. Feels so good. Yes! Halfway through, and it has only been about 10 minutes, not even quite 10 minutes yet. But this line is short. I have to finish this as fast as I possibly can. I only said about a 30-minute line at the front of this line. It has now been about 17 minutes. So definitely, that is completely worthwhile.
But it has actually been more like a 15-minute wait. Right now, I think we're sitting right at 18 minutes. So this is not going to be a very long line at all.
Fully on their body, so.
Actually, it's like 4:20 right now, something like that. So we're headed in the direction of Frontier Town. We're gonna check that out, and we picked up a couple strays along with us from my mine and Gibbons last video. So
hey, there's no problem with that.
So we're gonna hang out together. We're gonna do a little bit of watching Lusty Lils. I always love live, any kind of live entertainment. I love, but. I don't know why, but there's something about Lusty Lils that I'm here for Lil. I will be her man. So we are going to go check out Lusty Lils.
All right, and one more station for a cold drink. Love to see the water rides already open today. It is an extremely hot day. Cut to B-roll right now. But it is not going to be open until Memorial Day. I was told that by a worker this morning. Every time I go through this Cedar Creek Hollow, I feel like I absolutely need to film it. Like it's pretty. Just, it is pretty. It's cool.
And serene, and like, it gives you an extra pathway.
This is where we're going.
Oh no, it's going already. How's it going already?
I'm here today. Now, this is not the type of show where you go upstairs sit quietly and watch gladly.
We want to hear you hooting and hollering and
they have the live band back also.
All right. And Tiger Rats!
And I'm playing submarine. I love to go swimming with women. Inside, what a beautiful scene. Or die, die. Belly up, belly up, belly up, belly up. Woo! Hey! He's a sweet melody. Across the river, down Old Sandusky Way.
And I pass that to every front row and dairy. See the devil topple out of our seat. Man of Mary's band of battle slaying in the land of it. He's Lord Tank, right over on his hair. Throwing super wrong to be showing you some wrong. You're on bottom on the rack. On the down low air.
So basically, this show is the same as last year, 100%, but the costume changes, and it's inside now, are completely different than what they had last year. I really didn't think that they would like it. I thought it was going to be like, but, and it is not everyone's cup of tea, and that's okay, but it's definitely my cup of tea.
Good job, guys! Good job! I love you, Lusty Lou.
Thank you so much.
All right, let's see how big of a line Big Cedar Farm has. There are obviously a lot of people who have eaten here. I do see some people with pizza from Wagon Wheel also. And it doesn't look like it really has a line unless the line is just encapsulated inside, which is fine. Wow. Not much of a line at all. Like, way less than I thought there would be. You have two lines here, so they can open up two different lines. You have a choice of two different sauces. One is chimichurri. What's the other sauce called? Okay. And the other one is a romesco sauce. I'll take the... Oh. Both look so good. I'm going to try the smashed fried red potatoes. Yeah, they look really good. Thank you very much. It's the ceilings for me. I love the ceilings in here. We've even got some live music today. the seasoning on the steak looks delicious, and the seasoning on the potatoes looks incredible. The whole meal looks very nice. And then we've got chimichurri sauce over here. So we'll try that all out. Yeah, this time, given.
Chicken.
But speaking of biscuits, I feel like this meal is a much better meal to eat with biscuits because there's more juices and stuff on the plate for me to mop up with that biscuit. When there's nothing, it just, the biscuit has very little flavor. Honestly, there's not much flavor.
No.
No. Okay, only eat big chunks with the skin, because the skin is where all the flavor is. It probably could use like some butter or sour cream or something that you can put over the top of it, but. Yeah, it's a lot better with the skin. Making sure that you keep that skin with it because that's where it's been fried. Probably still not my favorite thing. Honestly though, with the steak, it's probably gonna taste absolutely delicious.
I mean, that's not saying a whole lot though. Potato always tastes good with steak.
Yeah, it has a good sear on it. It has the taste of the herbs and, you know, whatever the seasoning is. Really, really good. Let's add a little bit of chimichurri sauce into that. Chimichurri sauce is excellent.
And on the way, the trash cans are an option for you because they make it easy with your feet. So, I'm gonna go this way. Don't throw away the tray. And the other. All right. And now we are done. Gemini. It is late enough in the day that Magnum is not looking like a terrible wait. Oh no!
Is it down?
It's down.
It's down.
Never mind, we are not going to Magnum. We'll probably be able to come back.
Right. So POV, one of your favorite rides that you wanted to ride right now is down. What do you do next? You just keep on walking. We are headed down to Gatekeeper, and that's gonna be our next ride. Assuming it's open. This has actually been a pretty decent day.
Yeah, it's been pretty productive, I would say.
Yeah, we've done a lot more than I thought we were going to at the beginning with all the rain. How many rides have we done so far? Has it only been
really
six and three. A show? No, not three. Oh, three for you.
Yeah.
So five for me and a show. Maybe it's not that productive.
Of the day. Feels like it's been pretty productive.
I know. Why does it feel productive?
We've covered a lot of ground today, which is the important part.
Maybe
like
that's
seeing
it.
Everything again and like riding yeah. a couple things here and there. But that's the Cedar Point experience, is just taking everything in.
Especially if you can come frequently.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, if you can, if you're like me and you live 5 minutes away, it doesn't matter because I'm here all the time and it doesn't bother me that something may or may not be open.
Yeah.
I can just come back and ride it anytime I want. If you're coming from a long ways away, it's kind of important to prioritize and strategize your day at the park because you want to ride as much as possible, I'm sure, or see as much as possible.
And that's when it would be important to watch one of my, like, riding everything at Cedar Point in a day videos because it's going to give you more of an idea. And I'll be doing another one of those this year because every single year things change and crowds move around differently. So riding everything in one day becomes a different challenge every year, no matter what. Tiki Twirl is put back together, but it's not running today. It makes me wonder if they're gonna have it up and running soon or not. Get in that line and you will commit the rest of your night to that. And there are people on Gatekeeper. I don't think it's gonna be a fast wait, but it's something for us to ride, so let's see. I'm gonna hope this is gonna be shorter than a 45 minute wait, but I don't know. So we'll go figure it out. Hopefully Raptor will get a lower weight
this evening also, and same with Magnum, we can get several additional rides in. It's 6:10, and we have just now reached the stairs. It's not even a half hour yet. It's 6:10, which means we have been in line about 20 minutes, and this is looking like it's gonna be a pretty short line. We are here at the stairs right now. We got in line at 5:51. It is now 6:20. It's been a half hour. And we are headed right now. Let's go.
Keep your hands and arms.
Park side is secure.
All times and hold on until the ride comes to a.
That's my man Jeremiah Ferguson.
All clear.
Any item that cannot be secured in a waste.
Are you excited?
What's up?
Are you excited?
I'm so excited.
See inside the empty Wicked Twister lot right here.
Ready, gotta go.
Cedar Point is a popular place at night. The beginning of the year last year, I don't think was nearly as full as the beginning of the year this year is. People are still coming down from COVID, but now everything's going at full mast, including music days here. So you have a lot of students and just a ton of people here at the park today, which makes it more of a challenge. And that is part of the fun of it. We are going down to Raptor right now, Given's baby. And
it says 30 minutes.
We're gonna check it out. 30 minute wait is not bad. We can do that. Here at 6:34, let's see how long this line takes us. The line has gotten a lot bigger all of a sudden.
Because everyone's leaving and they're probably like one last ride.
Yeah, they're on their way out, yeah. That makes sense.
You got here in good time, it looks like.
Yeah. Also, I always stand a line that is getting longer than the line that I actually have to stand in. I am definitely a fan of that. Not my experience. Usually it seems like this line gets a lot shorter at the end of the night, but today that's definitely not the case. We did seem to hit this line at the perfect time though. Here is definitely something to do in line. Enjoy each other, play games. That is a great way to pass the time. If you're standing in line, find a game to play, do something online. Definitely a good way to pass a half hour line that you need to wait in. All right, guys, the line has migrated, but it is longer. No longer is it here, but they've filled up all the back and forth over there.
One of my favorite things in amusement parks is when people do stupid things. Like, just now, a group of, I don't know, 10 people start clapping, and then everyone started clapping. So much fun. I love it. And
that was very creative. I like that a lot.
It's literally been 33 minutes. Let's go! How'd your baby do?
My baby did good.
Your baby did good.
It's running phenomenally. It always does. I've never had a bad ride on Raptor. It's just consistently intense and fun as hell.
It is such a fun ride.
I love Raptor with every fiber of my soul. It is my favorite ride in this park, and it's in my top 10.
It really is a crazy ride, though. And
line's up to an hour now.
Yeah.
We really did catch it.
Yeah, line's an hour now. At least. I wouldn't doubt if that's longer than an hour. The crowds are going crazy today. Hey, guys, I got the Skyride running. Yay! I love the Skyride. And once again, everyone is just walking out of the park right now.
Do they not know we still have a half hour? Power Tower about to launch in 3, 2, 1. Woo!
It's on YouTube, man.
Yes. All right, let's see what the line is like. Well, not terrible.
10 minutes.
Not as good as I was hoping for, but not terrible. Hi, Heather. Nice to see you. Thank you for helping us.
No problem. Have a nice day.
Magnum at night is the fact that it may or may not have a wait. Right now, this looks to be about 10 minutes or so. So it's very, very doable. It's another ride that kind of earlier in the day will get a line. And it'll kind of peak around the afternoon, and then it'll die out in the evening. So this is a good ride to strategize. This is when I would recommend coming to do it, because it's been warmed up, running a bit faster, all that good stuff.
You guys all just heard Given just say that on his own vlog, which I think I just got all on video also. You definitely need to just agree with it and follow his advice. Yes. It is only 7:32 and we are ready to get on Magnum.
That's what I call strategy.
That was very good. Yes.
That blue train, how was that ride?
Well, that was fantastic. No way, Millennium Force is the best. Right now in the night, you have two choices. There's 20 minutes left in the night. You can either choose to do several smaller things that you can get on, you know, in a 5 or 10 minute wait and move straight from one to the next. And then hit one big ride at the end of the night. Or you can just hit a whole bunch of small stuff, or you can just go straight to something bigger that you've wanted to ride, but you haven't been able to. And then you'll make sure that you were able to get into it. Last year, they did close a couple of rides a little bit early. I'm not sure if they're doing that this year or not. But I would, I would go back to Steel Vengeance and they would say, we closed it 10 minutes ago. Because it had too long of a line, they had to evacuate the line, something like that. So what we are going to do is we have made the decision to ride which ride?
Millennium Forceless.
Yes, Forceless. You're full of crap. So Millennium Force it is. I'm so excited to go. I love this ride, despite what this guy says. Oh, I disagree. Right now, we are on our way to our last ride of the day, Millennium Force. And here it is, and I hear that classic music. That is not an hour long. Well, we just went down for maintenance. It wouldn't be a Cedar Point day if we didn't go down for maintenance at some point. Yeah, at least one ride. So, I don't know. We'll see what happens. The TV screen just said 7:55. We have 7:57, so either way, it's either 3 minutes or 5 minutes until park closing. So, we don't have a lot of time, so. We'll see if they let us on or not. I hope so.
All right. It's resuming operation. We just saw a ride. We just saw a train go up. So hopefully we'll be getting on quickly here.
It's been 22 years, and people are still so excited as soon as they get off of or get done with Millennium Force. That speaks huge things to me about the quality of this ride.
It is 8:29, and we are here. Let's go!
Given, are you excited?
I'm so excited!
Well, that was a moment.
much longer line than we anticipated, more like a 45-minute line, but it was because it broke down. Otherwise, it would have been a little bit less than that, but good. I mean, we are super excited. Let's go.
Let's go.
I see some girls behind me who are super excited also. I love this ride because of the speed down at the bottom. That's the thing that I love about it. I'm sure you have something to say about that.
So, yeah, it hugs the ground. But I like intensity, and that's something this ride doesn't really have after the first drop and turn, so...
I agree. I think that's why I like it. I don't like intensity as much as
not,
I like just like...
I love intensity.
Down it again?
Yes!
What'd you think? It's been a great day. The last 2 hours, we were able to hit four rides.
That's not bad at all.
And they were not small rides either.
No, and on a day when it's busy like this, like that's pretty solid.
Yeah.
So.
Gatekeeper and Millennium Force were two of those four rides. What else did we do? I don't remember.
Raptor and
Magnum?
Magnum.
Okay, Raptor and Magnum. Yeah, like those are huge lines, especially considering today. So the only one that really was a big line for us though was Raptor. Millennium Force is such a great ride. What a great day here at Cedar Point. I am so glad that you guys are coming along with me on these theme park journeys. Let me know what else you guys want to see. And if there's other things that I can work on to give you guys a little bit more of an idea, a detailed view into Cedar Point and what's happening here, because I do the theme park so you don't have to, but I know you'll want to anyway. Always meeting new friends. What are your names again?
My name is Court.
Okay.
Carter. Salt Lake City, Utah.
Oh, awesome.
Drove here.
Man.
Drove.
They said they've been watching the videos, so it's nice to meet you guys.
Yeah.
And what are your favorite coasters here?
So we've only ridden two because we got here so late. We rode, what did we ride?
Corkscrew and Gatekeeper.
Okay, so the best out of those two is...
Obviously Gatekeeper.
Yeah,
okay.
Obviously.
Before we continue, the only park we've ever been to is Lagoon in Utah.
I don't
know if you've ever heard of that.
No,
theme park.
I haven't.
It's got some really cool rides, but nothing compares to this.
Yeah. Sure.
Like, I've never experienced anything like it.
Yeah.
Just those two rides.
Yeah. Yeah, well, crazy. I mean, Gatekeeper is one of the best I've ever
And we still haven't even done Steel Vengeance or, like, the other ones.
Yeah, if you... Millennium of Steel Vengeance are going to blow you away.
And we got fast passes for tomorrow.
Okay.
Even though it's
awesome.
Probably going to be dead anyways.
Well, that I mean, you're coming from far enough away. That'll probably be helpful.
Yeah.
So, hey, it was so nice meeting you guys.
And thanks to this guy. He's the reason why we're here right now. He convinced us to come.
That's awesome. I'm glad to hear it. You guys have a great day.
Right, you
see you guys.
Bye.
Thanks for
saying. I have never experienced the store being locked before, but it is locked. So I guess we're going the other way. People out on the beach tonight. Such a nice night. Not sure if the pool's open or not. Kiddie pool is definitely open and going. Now, I'm not sure if the bar's open here or not. We're gonna have to see.
I'm just looking for
some water.
There's definitely more people out here than there were the last day that I was here. Now, it's toes in the sand time. First time, I mean, without it being a joke. Popular place here for takeout. If you are interested in, you know, getting pizza or something like that, this is a great place to get that. But it's time to get out on the beach right now. So let's go. Also, look at that. Every time, I even took off my shirt twice today, and I still, it looks like I'm wearing a very deep V, even when I have my shirt off.
So, what are your names again?
Griffin.
So we're out on the beach. I just met some cool guys. It's nice to meet them. And the sand is cold. The sand is real, real cold. But I get to hang out on the beach and put my toes in it. And you know what? Cold sand isn't gonna stop me. We're not gonna stop. We are going to do it. I need it. I need this. I've been waiting to get out here for so long. So we're gonna hang out here for just a little bit and do a little bit of walking up and down the beach just because I've missed it. And I'm gonna head home because I'm singing at church in the morning. And it's just such a serene, fun place to go visit. Actually, I'm surprised because I swear I got bit by a bug earlier, but I'm not feeling bug bites. Like I had one on my kneecap earlier, but yeah, it's nice not having that now.
The empty Magnum and Cedar Point Shores skyline right in front of me.
It's a different kind of a feel though, with so many like kids hanging out or like young people, you know? I think it's just, yeah, younger people. I'll just say that.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah.
He dropped it! Oh, he dropped it!
What was that safety, bro?
Hey, I had Tardu! Yeah! He had Tardu too!
Man, it's hard to walk in that sand. Good exercise though, so I'm okay with it. It does look like there's a pool that's open. There are actually people in this pool.
There are quite a few people in this pool. Along with some workers. As this night wears on, this beach is getting louder and louder. Man, look at all the people out on the beach today.
So, it's about time to get our stuff and to head out. Even more people here than there was earlier.
Is this my favorite part of Ellie's life? He's got like the ribbed up in his other arm.
Yeah, you know what?
I gotta ask you, Jeff. What did Reese tell you? Because I tell the Reese and it's bullshit. It's bullshit.
Lots of people at the hot tub. Lots of people at the pool. Actually have never seen this shut before, but it is shut, so you can get locked out, but you can always still walk straight down the beach. There is an exit down the beach. The problem is you kind of have to walk through water, so I'm gonna go take off my shoes. Thank you guys so much for watching this today. I have enjoyed immensely coming here. Also, I hope that you guys have a great night. Please keep on going. Be kind to each other. And let's go! Doing some testing of Windseeker. So we have to walk way out here in order to get onto the beach because of the way this is set up. So this is going to be a trek. It's not that easy to walk in sand. At least the waves have died down substantially from the other day. So we don't have nearly as many waves right now. So I'm just going off onto the beach. As a matter of fact, you can see how the sand is still pretty freshly tilled. You can see how far away the wall is. I mean, it's dark, but you can see where the line starts. So you've got quite a bit of space between the waves and where the wall hits. Just if the waves are extremely high because of high winds, it's gonna be hard at that point.
to walk down here, but right now, not a problem at all. Let's listen to that peaceful sound of the waves coming in. 28,420 steps. That's where I am right now. It looks like there are no staircases that are open until the very, very ending one. So it is, for all intents and purposes, closed along the boardwalk. Oh, there is actually a fence up here blocking off Cedar Point Beach. That's funny. I mean, I know I can get through here, and I've seen some people come through here too. They didn't get in trouble or anything, so. I mean, I imagine they want me to leave to go to my car at some point. We're gonna stop and put my shoes on. Bye, Cedar Point. It does say boardwalk closed beyond this point. Gotta have a way to get out of here.